is Paul Arsulf, and I'm the president of RS Technologies. The title of this presentation is Google's Project Ara versus Project RS. And the presentation is about comparing design proposals for smartphones and devices. Best components matter. Mic should be a little further. Like this.
Okay.
Does competence matter? This was the topic of a blog post that I wrote last year. I heard about Google's project Ara about maybe end of May or June last year. And I did download the documents they're offering. And the more I was reading the documents, the more disturbed I became, to the point of writing a blog post questioning the competence of Google's engineers. And you, you may ask yourself, who the hell are you, to question the Google's competence. As it happens, I get to live and work in US, including the Silicon Valley, and I'm intimately familiar with the culture out there. So I think some of you here in the audience are going to be better than the ordinary Google engineer. One thing about Google's culture is they allow their engineers and creative types to work one day out of the 5-day work weeks on their personal projects. Of course, whatever is created by these three projects belongs to the company. And I think Project Ara started as one of these creative days projects. So what is Project Ara? Project Ara is about adding functionality to mobile devices. It's about connecting hardware to phones and other devices. And it's also a radical new design. Google is primarily a software company. And unfortunately, they do not understand much of designing for hardware. So here's what actually a Google Ara device is going to look like, or it's looking like. Here we have that's the top of the device, and that's the bottom of the device. The idea is of connecting modules to the device on the top and bottom. And here you can see the skeleton of the device, and there are modules with different sizes. And I think that's a display module, that's a battery module, which is supposed to come here. And these two are camera modules. What is Project ARS? So it's easy to just question something and dislike something. But I went further, and so I did write a counter proposal, and I called it Project ARS. It's in the same way, it's about adding functionality, connecting hardware, but it's through using of the existing mobile phone devices. So it's about putting connectors to the side of the device, then wiring these connectors to standard interfaces so that people can connect external devices. Devices like this are manufactured in essentially billions of units quantities. Here is what actually Project ARS intends to do. Some of the devices may be connected directly to a mobile phone device, as on the top picture, or on the bottom of the picture, a cable can be connected to the connector of segments. Then it goes to extension board and additional hardware maybe mounted out there. So what is wrong with Project Tower? The first thing I don't like is mechanical limits about adding height, and it makes the phone much thicker. The modules we saw in the previous picture of Google Aura are about 4 millimeters in height. And if we add top and bottom, so these are like 8 millimeters, so it makes a normal device maybe 30 to 50% thicker than it is right now. And so it makes, like if I have to put another device in my pocket, it's going to bulge out of my pocket. So I need maybe to get a holster to carry this device. Another thing is like underutilized space. When you look at the bottom of Project Tower device, like where the modules are, some of these modules are going to be empty shells, waiting to be replaced with functional module. So it kind of underutilizes the space and leaves lots of empty space. In contrast with this, Project Tower sets only connectors to the side of the device. As a designer and as an engineer, I can live maybe with the mechanical issues, but electrical issues and software is significant, which makes me think many times if I have to design actually a device based on Project Tower. What Google proposes is like connecting the microprocessor of the device to a brick chip, which is compliant with Google specs. And this chip brings like maybe around 10 to 12 pins, which are for connecting to modules. And from this interface, the designer has to have additional hardware, which goes to further than to standard interfaces like SDAO, USB, etc. The microprocessor of one unit already, a unit like this, it has a microprocessor. And the microprocessor essentially has already the interfaces, the standard interfaces. So it's ironic that Google Aura, like a standard device like this, has already the USB and SDAO interfaces, and Google Aura device doesn't have these things. So there are some missing things in Project Aura, which I propose in my proposal with Project Ares. There are two components. One of them is software engine. An Android device like this comes with a specific version of Android operating system. So it has very limited upgradability. The device maker may make a release of maybe the next release of Android, but they're not going further than this. And the user of the device is reluctant to make an upgrade of the firmware because they can essentially break the device. They don't want to take this chance. So the first component is software engine, which provides upgradability and brings API set to the Android operating system. In order to explain the second component, device driver binary builder kit, I have to make some definitions. And the first definition is of a kernel. Kernel is a layer of system software which runs on the top of the hardware. It animates the hardware and It provides system services to the user space and allows user space to graph the interface and communicate with keyboard and mouse. Android environment runs on the top of Linux operating system, of Linux kernel. And then the second definition I want to make is of a device driver. A device driver is a piece of software which controls specific hardware, and it belongs to the, either it's part of the kernel or it's like added to the kernel. The second component, device driver binding toolkit, allows portability. Let's say I design a device driver for a piece of hardware, which is for this device. The way Linux kernel operates is like I cannot use the binary of the driver for one device to on another device. So we did design is like an utility which allows adjusting of the binary of the device drivers to work between different devices, and it allows hardware portability. So what now? What's next? What is the future holding? ID3 that project Ara devices have been released in specifically in Puerto Rico, and the cost of a device like this is something like $800. In addition to this, I did read that there have been a conference on Google Sara designers in the beginning of this year, in January. But my guess is like Project Ara is going to get limited traction, or it may go in the way of Google Glass. For those of you who are not familiar, Google Glass is like something which looks like a glass, which combines the outside view with projected images. Initially, the project was very exciting for people, and they kind of couldn't wait to get device. But once Google released it to the public, like the response was lukewarm, and the project is considered like high-level failure for Google. What is the future holding for Project RS? It depends on the device makers, whether they're going to embrace it. Okay. Questions? You better ask questions because I'm going to start asking. Okay. Well, if it's Kickstarter, it's probably not Google R, because Google R is like sponsored by Google. They have enough funding. They don't want to cross anything. Other questions? Okay, my first question to you is like, what is the kernel? Anyone? Once again, a kernel, besides sounding like military rank, it's like a layer of system software which runs on top of the hardware, and it provides important system services so that the user space can have graphical interface and interact with keyboard and mouse. Okay, my second question is like, here's the question. Um, I did is like making some kind of account of proposal to Google Google project. ROI is a radical new design, and mechanically it's very different than existing devices. So what I was thinking is like billions of devices are coming in a certain form factor, and it's better to make an evolution of existing designs versus a radical new design. Questions? I'm probably out of time. I'm done now. Thank you.